Guys, I just finished taking my first test of nursing 106. It wasn't bad. I don't like to say, oh, I know I did good or anything like that, because I don't like to jinx myself. So we're just gonna wait and see what we got. So today we were able to go in person and take our test at the school with some of our classmates. At first I thought I wasn't gonna be able to focus, but honestly it wasn't that bad. But overall the test wasn't bad. Even though I was only here to take a test, I liked being on campus. So tomorrow I'm looking forward to my class being held on campus. Right now I'm about to go to my aunt's school. She is teaching her CNA class, vital signs, today. So I'm just going to sit in on that lecture and demonstration, just because, like I explained to you guys before, when I did the vital signs skills lab at my school, I didn't feel really confident about it when we were done. Like, it kind of was rushed through a little bit. And I do start clinicals on March 29th. And we're going to have to take vital signs. I'm just going to go sit in on her demonstration for that. I'm going to take you guys with me and show you guys a little bit of that. So that should be fun. So yeah, that's where I'm headed. I'm going to try to get my reaction for my test grade on camera. I know I say this all the time and I fail to do it. But since I'm going to be recording today and I have my camera with me, I should be able to catch my reaction. So stay tuned.
Remember, before we do anything to a patient, we get their permission. So this is how you get the range. You know, a normal temperature is 98.6, right? So this is your normal, 98.6. You go 10 down, which is 97. Go 10 up, which is 99. So when they ask you the range, that's your range. When they ask you the normal temperature, it's this. Mm-hmm. Got it? A normal person should have 100% oxygen. But most people have like 97, 98, and that's all right. We're okay with that. But when people start getting like 88, 85, that's serious. The body's not getting enough oxygen, and the brain needs oxygen to live. If you don't get enough oxygen to the brain, it will die. That's why when we do CPR, it's so important, when that heart stops, to jump on it, because that blood brings that oxygen to that brain. And if you don't jump on it, that brain's going minutes without oxygen. After 4 to 6 minutes, even if you bring them back, that person's going to be brain dead the 9 days. And then if it stays high like that, then we put them on hypertension medication. Hypertension medication is called anti-hyper. So if somebody's hyperglycemic, what's wrong with them?
Too much sugar.
Very good. If they're hypoglycemic, what's wrong with them?
Not enough.
You got it? Hypo is low. Hyper is up. What is tacky?
Fast.
Very good. Somebody who's tachycardy is what?
Fast.
And what's a normal pulse rate?
60 to 100.
And when you're measuring a pulse, what are you measuring?
The beats per minute.
The beats per minute of what?
Your heart.
Very good. When you're taking a respiration, what are you measuring?
The breathing.
What organ is that?
The lungs.
Very good. All right. When somebody's going through chain stroke breathing, tell me about it.
They're doing all of them.
And when did that normally happen?
Right before.
Very good. What is dyspnea?
Difficulty breathing.
Very good. What's a normal Fahrenheit temperature?
98.6.
Very good. What's a normal Celsius temperature?
37.
Y'all read that board?
No.
Okay. What's a normal range for a systolic pressure?
100 to 19.
Systolic. Give me a diastolic. If you suspect a person has a temperature, what are you going
to
do?
Just take
their temperature. to get the most accurate pulse. When you're gonna do it and how you're gonna do it.
The apical
and what you're gonna do, how you gonna do it?
Stethoscope
for how long?
Minute.
Okay, if you want the most accurate temperature, what you gonna do?
Rectal.
What color is the thermometer?
Green.
What position?
Same.
How deep?
One half to one fourth.
And are you gonna, what else you gonna do?
You gonna hold it.
You gonna hold it and what else?
Lubricate.
What else you gonna put on you to protect you?
Blood.
Very good. And you gonna also raise that bed. Mm-hmm. Because if you have a lot of patients that you have to go to and you're constantly doing this, you're gonna wear your body out. So you wanna pump that bed up. Because remember what I always taught y'all, you can't protect nobody and help nobody to protect yourself. So you're gonna pump that bed up, put that patient in Sam's position, and then hold that thermometer, okay? What does the pulse oximeter measure?
Oxygen.
The oxygen in the blood. What's a normal pulse oximeter?
100.
We want it 100%, okay? Mm-hmm. I think it's 94 if it goes too low is when we have to put the patient on vents, the breathe form. What's the medical term for high blood pressure?
You said high blood pressure, hypertension.
Hypertension, very good. And what's the medical initials for hypertension is HTN. Okay, because y'all gonna see that a lot in the charts. They're not gonna say hypertension, they're gonna say HTN. Somebody tell me what a pulse deficit is. Challenge yourself on that one.
That's the difference in pulse sizes from the apical and the other ones.
Go boy. Your pulse deficit is the difference between your apical pulse and any other site that the doctor tells you. Where's your pedal pulse?
Very good.
What's the most common temperature site?
Four.
What's the most accurate temperature site?
Mm-hmm.
What's the most common pulse site?
Radio.
Okay. What's your most accurate pulse site?
The apical.
Very good. How do you take a respiration and why?
You take it while they're not paying attention so you can get an accurate reading.
Very good. And what's the normal pulse rate? You're over there. You're in three. They're coming.
60 to 100.
Very good, y'all. What's the name of this?
Man.
Everybody in the group chat is saying that grades are up. So let's see. I'm nervous. I felt kind of okay about it, but like, I don't know. I'm so nervous. Fingers crossed that I pass. I passed. Test one is out of here. We passed. Moving on to the next.
Patient had a mastectomy or had a dialysis shunt or something in the arm to prevent you from doing that. You want to make sure the cuff is tight, and then you want to check to make sure you can get at least two fingers underneath so it's not too tight. You're going to have the artery at the artery. You clean these things?
Mm-hmm.
You're going to check this stethoscope to make sure it's working. And it's audio.
Bye.
The acoustics is good.
You're welcome.
You're gonna put it by the break your artery. And then you're gonna watch the spirometer go up. Put it up to about 130, 140.
Jesus, your pulse rate, your blood pressure is only 98 over 74. Did you hear it?
I am done with the vital signs with my aunt and her class. I am currently on my way to an animal shelter, to meet with my cousin Maya. Y'all know Maya, y'all didn't see her face in two of my vlogs if y'all watched them. She wants to go to an animal shelter for whatever reason. So that's why I'm about to meet her. And then I'm going to get out these clothes. I had to pass the animal shelter up before I got back to her apartment where my clothes are. So I was like, let me just go past first, because honestly, when I go inside, I don't want to come out. I'm tired. I went to bed at like 3 this morning because I was up studying for my test. I woke up at 6:30 to get ready because I had to be to school for 8 o'clock. So yeah, I've been on go ever since and I'm tired. So I will see you guys when we get to the animal shelter.
This one is so cute.
Come on.
Yeah. Oh, she's hungry.